positive levels of inflation can be good. It could indicate that the economy is growing and demand is strong. Inflation becomes a problem when it is not manageable and when it cannot be predicted. Unexpected inflation harms economic activity. In this video, we will talk about two things. First, we will discuss the CPI and its accuracy. And second, we will discuss the cost of unexpected inflation on society. Let us start with the concern that CPI might not be an accurate measure of the cost of living. CPI can overestimate the true level of inflation in three ways: the substitution bias, changes in quality bias, new product and location bias. The substitution bias is the idea that people substitute away from goods that experience an increase in price. Since CPI holds the basket constant, it will overestimate the true cost of living. For instance, if CPI basket includes coffee and coffee becomes more expensive, people might substitute towards tea. Since 1999, the BLS has used a formula to adjust for shifts in consumption. Changes in quality is another bias that is introduced in the CPI. Over time, technology advances increase the life and usefulness of products. Although their price might increase, their cost per year or per use actually falls because we are using them for longer periods of time. A good example is cars. In the 1980s and 90s, cars would last 5 years on average before they start falling apart. It was common to see cars stranded on the side of the road. Today, cars cost more, but they last much longer. It is common for cars to last 10 to 12 years. New product and location bias. Historically, the BLS used to keep the basket of goods constant for long periods of time. It has since reduced the time in which it updates the basket and has introduced other measures of CPI to avoid this bias. The issue we face here is by keeping the basket constant for long periods of time, it won't reflect new products that are used by consumers. New products are often expensive but fall in price quickly, and this will not be reflected in the CPI. And that's how the CPI might be overestimating the cost of living. Let us move to the cost of inflation. Here are all the costs of inflation. As price levels increase, holding money becomes costly. And this is what we call shoe leather cost. The longer you hold on to the money, the less it is worth. This creates an incentive for people to spend their money. The term originally got its name from the idea that people would have to visit the bank often to withdraw money to spend it on goods. Today, shoe leather cost reflects the time and effort, or opportunity cost of time and effort, that people expend by holding less cash in order to avoid the cost of inflation. Money illusion is a common cost that people face with inflation. It is when people mistake nominal changes for real changes. When you receive a 3% increase in your wages and you start to spend it as if it's an increase in real wages, but inflation increases unexpectedly to 5%, are you worse off? You are. So money illusion is when you receive a nominal increase in wages, but you believe it's a real increase in wages and it is not. Menu costs are the cost of changing prices. For example, if Walmart chooses to increase prices, they must reprint all price labels using their capital and other inputs, and more labor hours to replace the price tags. The cost to Walmart of the paper, ink, rental cost of printing machines, and workers are part of menu cost. Some firms try to reduce menu cost by using digital or erasable menus. Some might avoid putting prices on the menu altogether, especially if they face volatile prices. Future price level uncertainty. This cost is associated with unexpected or uncertainty about price levels and how it leads firms to prefer short-term contracts over long-term contracts. It becomes harder to plan for the future and take on economic activity and opportunities when you're uncertain about prices. Therefore, uncertainty about inflation might lead to a reduction in GDP as economic agents try to avoid making mistakes. Price confusion is the cost of not knowing the real reason why prices are going up. An increase in price can be due to an increase in demand or an increase in inflation. If a business owner realizes that their product can be sold for a higher price, they might take on new investments, build new factories, and hire workers because they assume their product is more profitable. In reality, it might be due to inflation. And if that's the case, then those investments would not be worthwhile and actually will hurt the firm in the long run. Wealth distribution between lenders and borrowers is another cost. When lenders agree to lend a borrower money, they charge a price for that service. That price is in terms of interest rate. That interest rate reflects their cost. One of the costs that goes into that is inflation. If inflation is higher than the lender expected, inflation would eat at their profits. The borrower would also be able to pay the loan back with what we call cheaper dollars, since we assume that their wages went up because of inflation as well. Let's take an example. Suppose you borrow $100,000 at a 5% interest rate. If unexpected inflation occurs, you are better off and the bank is worse off. If the inflation was expected, then the bank would have required more in return for the loan. They would have charged a higher interest rate to begin with. If unexpected deflation occurs, then you are worse off and the bank is better off. The final cost is tax distortion. Capital gains taxes are taxes on the gains realized by selling an asset for more than what you purchased it at. The problem is that often the price rises due to inflation rather than an increase in the value of the good. Let's look at an example. If you buy a house in 1980 for $80,000 and sell the house in 2012 for $230,000, the capital gain is equal to $150,000, and you have to pay taxes on $150,000. However, during the same time period, the CPI rose from 80 to 230 in those years. So the real value of the house is the same. The real gain is equal to zero. These costs indicate why inflation can be troublesome for the economy and individuals as they try to make decisions. In this video, we discuss two main issues. First, we discuss some biases that arise with the CPI calculation. And second, we discuss why inflation, specifically unexpected inflation, can cause issues in the economy. Try out the problems and see you in the next class.